is, my parents are from Brazil.
他们是从巴西来的。
And they, God spoke to them when they were children.
当他们小孩子的时候，神已经对他们说话。
That they were going to be missionaries to America.
就是他们会在美国成为一位宣教士。
And that they would witness the greatest revival that the world has ever seen.
他们见证在世界有史以来发生最大的这个复兴。
Which still has not come.
就是还没有到那个复兴。
So it's coming.
所以我们相信那个复兴在前头了已经。
You know that when God speaks to children and gives promises to children,
you 知道当神给儿女子小孩子这些的启示的时候，神要成就。
And so they came in 1983, right?
所以1983年的时候他们来到。
I was that pastor's son that didn't really care about God or church.
就是我是牧者的儿子，但是我不是很关注教会，不是很关注耶稣。
You know, the church is just my second home.
就教会好像我另外一个家一样。
I'm there like almost every day.
就好像每一天都要在教会里面。
I hear all the sermons and all the worship songs all the time.
听过不同的敬拜音乐，听过不同的讲道。
And so you just get used to it.
那你就已经很习惯了。
And it's not very powerful to you.
已经因为太习惯，所以已经觉得没有能力。
And but then something happened.
那之后发生了一点事情。
We were actually kicked out of our church.
我们就是从教会里面被赶出来。
For praying too much.
就是因为我们祷告太多。
They thought my parents were going crazy because we were praying so much.
他觉得我们的父母好像已经发疯了，因为他们常常的祷告。
For a revival.
为着复兴，得着复兴而祷告。
And that caused us for about 6 months to, in those trials.
所以在这个困难，我们经历了六个月。
To seek God.
去寻求神更多。
And so my parents started going to all these prayer meetings like 4 or 5 times a week.
所以我父母开始就是一个星期4、5次的去到祷告会里面。
And they would take my brother and I with them.
他会带我跟我的兄弟一起去。
And in those prayer meetings, I would see people who really knew God.
在这些祷告会里面，我看见这些人真的非常认识神。
I started to see people healed of sicknesses.
我开始看见有人被神医治了。
I started to see people manifest in the spirit.
我看见人怎样在灵里面彰显。
And people prophesy.
就是怎么有先知的预言。
And I saw people that were doing 40-day fasts.
我看见有人就是做一个40天的禁食。
I was like, these people are crazy.
我觉得这些人真的疯了。
But they know God.
但是他们认识神。
I don't know God.
我不认识神。
I thought I knew God.
我以为我认识神。
But I don't.
但是其实我不懂。
And I realized that I just knew about God.
我可以知道原来我只是知道关于神的事。
But I didn't actually personally know.
但是我个人来讲我不认识。
Little by little, God started to change me.
慢慢的，神开始改变我。
And it was about a 1 year process.
差不多经历了一年的时间。
And when I was 12 years old,
当我12岁的时候，
I decided to follow Jesus.
我决定我要跟随耶稣。
With my whole heart.
用我全心。
And I said, you know, for me, I do things all or nothing.
对我来说，我一就不做，做的就要做的最好。
I don't like to do things just halfway.
我不喜欢就是做一半不做一半。
And so I said, Jesus, if I'm going to follow you, I'm going to go all the way.
所以我对耶稣说，如果我要跟随你，我要全心的跟随你。
And I thought to myself, what is the craziest thing that people do in the Bible and that Christians do right now?
所以我就问，在圣经里面有一些什么疯狂，最疯狂的事，就是在圣经里面有做的事情。
And at the time, I said, you know what? 40-day fast, that's crazy.
然后我说，40天的禁食，那是最疯狂的事。
And I said, you know what? That's what I'm going to do.
然后我说，这个就是我要做的事。
I'm going to do a 40-day fast, and I'm going to seek God.
我要做在这个40天的禁食里面，我要寻求神。
And so me and my best friend, he was 15, I was 12.
所以我跟我最好的朋友，他是15岁，我12岁。
We did a 40-day fast together.
我们进行一起进行了这个40天的禁食。
It wasn't just water. I had bread and fruits.
不是纯水，就是也有，就是水果也有这个面包。
And that's what I did for 40 days.
然后我40天这样子。
And praise God, I had amazing parents.
赞美神，我有非常好的父母。
That let me do it.
让我可以这
Because some parents would not let their 12-year-old do a 40-day fast. My mom argued with me. She was like, no, you're a growing boy.
You need to eat.
But I told her, no, mom, I gotta do this. And so I did a 40-day fast. And every day, it forced me to spend at least an hour with God. Because before I would only spend time with God if I felt like it.
以前就是我觉得要亲近神的时候，我才亲近神。But
when you're fasting,
但是当你进食的时候,
if you don't spend time with God, you might as well just eat.
如果你就是跟神反正都没有沟通的话，就是没有什么差别。And
so it forced me to pray every day.
所以就逼着我一定要去亲近神。
And out of that, I just fell in love with Jesus. For the first time, I started to hear His voice. For the first time, the Bible became alive to me. And so for a whole year, I started to spend 2 to 4 hours with God a day. And then when I was 13, I had a second encounter with God. I was in my mom's walk-in closet because that was my prayer room. And I had just prayed for about 2 hours. And I walk out of the closet. And I overhear my brother talking with my dad. And my brother is talking with him and saying, Dad, I don't get it. Is hell really real? I mean, can you prove it to me in the Bible? And so my dad said, yeah, of course it's real. And so he opens the Bible and goes through all these scriptures with him. And at the end of it, my brother says, so if hell is real, what the heck are we doing? Why are we just going to church all the time? Why are we just singing songs and having barbecues? Shouldn't we just be going out and telling everyone about this place and that they shouldn't go there? My dad said, you're right. And that convicted me. And then the next day, I went to pray, and I couldn't pray because the conviction from the night before was still strong. And then the Holy Spirit spoke to me, and the Holy Spirit's very blunt with me because I'm a blunt person. And I think the Holy Spirit speaks to us according to our character sometimes and how we receive it. And so he says to me this.
He
says, Joshua,
Joshua,
look at you. You're so selfish. Look at all that I've given you. I've given you an amazing family, amazing friends, an amazing church. I've given you the gospel. You're in my presence every day. You bask in my word every day. I came and I died for you. I've done all of this. I've given you all of this, Joshua. And you haven't shared it with one person. So selfish. And all of a sudden, I felt the weight of the world fall on my shoulders. And for 6 hours, I was on the carpet of my bedroom floor.
我在我睡房的那个地毯上面
crying and weeping that the world is going to hell and I'm doing nothing about it.
我在哭，为什么整个世界要走向地狱，但是我什么都不能做。
And I was saying, God, have mercy on me.
我说神啊，怜悯我。
I don't know what to do, Lord, but use me.
我不知道怎样做，但是神使用我。
I'm 13 years old. I don't know how to preach the gospel.
13岁，我不知道怎样去跟人家布道。
I don't know how to save people or talk to people.
我不知道怎样去拯救人，怎样去跟人对话。
The Lord used me. Do whatever it takes.
但是神使用我，做什么都可以。
And I just started weeping and crying out to God.
然后我就这样子对神呼喊。
And I literally could not stand up.
然后我是真的不能够站起来。
There were times I tried to get up, but there was a physical weight on my body where I could not get up.
我尝试去站起，但是我觉得我就是我身体上面真的有这个重量。
And for 6 hours, I was there just crying out to God for souls.
6个小时，我是在地毯上面，我就为灵魂我去呼喊神。
And I don't believe that we're supposed to walk around with the weight of the world on our shoulders.
我不觉得我要在这个世界重量放在我的身上，我这样子去走路。
That's God's burden to carry.
那是神的负担。
His burden for us is easy, and His yoke is light.
他给我们他的担子是轻省的。
But I do believe.
但是我相信。
That sometimes.
有时候。
God gives us the privilege
神给我们有这个特权
to feel what He feels
去感受他所感受的
for a brief moment
在一个短暂的时间
And I believe that's what happened to me that day
那我相信那一天发生的事就是这样子
that I felt His heart for the lost
我感受到他对这个世上灵魂的心
I could feel His heartbeat
我可以感受他的心跳
It was like my heart was here,
好像我的心在这里
and his heart was here.
他的心在这里
And as I encountered him,
当我与他越来越近的时候
our hearts became one.
我们心成为一样
And my heart started to beat.
然后我的心开始这样子跳动
at the same rhythm that his heart was beating.
跟神的跳动是一模一样
My heart started to burn.
我的心开始火热
with the same love and the same compassion.That his heart burns with. And all of a sudden, I had this reckless, relentless spirit. That I had to win the loss. No matter what it takes. And this overwhelming love. For people.
就是为人对人的爱
overtook
就是这样子的让我
before I didn't care about people
以前我从来不关注人
I just had fun I was a kid and I loved God
就是玩玩就好就是我
but after that encounter I could never look at people the same
但是当跟神有这个对话有这个相遇的时候不能再这样子
I just loved them so much
我就爱这些人
And then that night,
然后那天晚上
my dad comes home from work.
我爸爸从工作回来
And my mom, says to him,
我妈跟他说
Paul, look at your son. He's just been crying that the world's going to hell all day.
Paul, 你看看你儿子，他就是每一天就这样子，对世上灵魂就哭。
Go take him out to preach the gospel.
你就带他出去，就是在街上布道吧。
And so my dad says, okay.
然后我爸说好。
Let's have dinner first, and then we'll go.
我先吃晚餐，然后我们出去。
And so we eat.
然后他吃了晚餐。
And then we start driving around.
我们就开始就是开车。
We lived in Oxnard at the time.
我们在 Oxnard 这个地方。
In Ventura County.
在 Ventura County.
And it's a very Mexican area.
非常就是很多墨西哥人的这个地区。
And we speak Spanish.
然后我们就是我们会讲这个西班牙语。
And so we were driving around.
So, 当我们驾驶的时候
And we found a strip of Mexican bars.
我就看见有一对的这个墨西哥人的他们的酒吧
And my dad said, "Oh, this is perfect. Let's go here."
我爸说，哦，太好了，我们就在这里。
And so my dad and I went there from 9 o'clock to about 1 in the morning.
所以我跟我就在从晚上九点到凌晨一点。
and preach the gospel.
就这样子全福音布道。
And from that point on, every Friday night, my dad and I did that the whole summer.
从那时起，我就是啊，在整个暑假，就是我跟我爸每天啊，每一个星期五，我们都这样子做。
And we saw prostitutes come to Christ.
我们看见妓女他们去认识神。
We saw drug addicts, drunkards come to Christ.
看见那一些毒品啊，有毒瘾，有就是酒瘾的人，他们去认识神。
Eventually, we brought our youth group.
就我们就是开展那个青年人的时候。
And we would go inside the bars with music.
我们就是在这个青年之后，我们去到这个酒吧，我们用音乐。
And just start worshiping and take over the whole bar.
开始就是我们占据这些酒吧，然后我们开始赞美神。
And then we would prophesy over the people.
然后为人我们发预言。
And they would start crying.
我们孩子开始哭，然后就得救。
It was awesome.
非常好。
And so that marked me, and since I was 13, I couldn't stop.
因为那是非常特别，我13岁的时候。
And since then, I just preach the gospel.All the time.
从那时起，我就常常的传福音，每一天每一个星期，我都这样子传福音。
And actually, when I was about 15,
当我差不多十五岁的时候
，I was inspired by your people.
被你们这些人，我非常的受激励。
I started to read about the underground church in China.
我开始就是对中国的地下教会非常有兴趣，我开始读关于这些的书。
It's actually an honor for me to be speaking to you today.
对，非常我荣幸能够今天来到这里跟你们说话。
Because what God has done in China.
因为神在中国所做的。
Is what has inspired me my entire life.
激励了我。激励了我的人生。
To see revival in America.
去看见美国也要有复兴。
The faith and the sacrifice and the lifestyle that the believers live there.
那些信徒他们的信心，他们的牺牲。
Gives me hope that something like that could happen here in America.
让我有盼望，想让在美国也要看见这样子的这个复兴。
And you have no idea.
你不知道。
How much.The Chinese church has inspired the whole world.
影响了，激励了整个的世界。
It's provoked Americans.
让美国受到激励。
It's challenged us.
也挑战美国。
To live more radically for Christ.
让我们为神更加的去做事。
And so when I started reading about the underground church in China,
当我读关于这个中国地下教会的故事的时候
，God continued to highlight to me.
就特别的让我看见
about this thing called itinerant preachers
啊，关于这个的布道
and it's this thing that happens in China with the believers there
啊，在中国啊，这些信徒所经历的
where they get saved
他们得救
and they just quit their job
他们就放弃了他们的工作
or they leave their farm
然后离开了他们农场
and they just start walking.
Or
riding their bicycle,
或是在骑单车
and they just start going and preaching the gospel.
我们就去到每个地方，他们就这样子去布道
and they'll do it for 6 months or a year or 2 years.
他们就半年、一年、两年，他们这样做
and then come back home,
然后回家
work some more,
做一些工作
and then go out again.
然后又再次出去
and it's just part of the underground church culture.
这就是那个地下教会他们的文化
and I was shocked.
我非常震惊，当时。
And I said, why don't we live like that?
我想，为什么我们不能这样子活
？Why don't we have faith?
为什么我们没有同样的信心
？And said, so I made a covenant with God when I was 15.
所以十五岁的时候，我与神立约。
I said, God, I don't know how.
我说神，我不知道怎样。
And I don't know when.
我不知道什么时候。
But one day.
但是有一天。
I'm gonna raise up for you an army.
我要为主你兴起。
Of itinerant preachers in America and in Europe in the Western world.
在西方的世界里面也兴起这样子的布道家。
To re-evangelize the Western world.
去重新的去再改变这个西方的世界。
And so I just continued living my life.
所以我继续的生活。
Not knowing when that would happen.
不知道那个到底要什么时候发生。
And then I finished community college.
然后我完成我的社区学院。
And I was going to go to a 4-year university.
我本来是要去这个四年的这个大学。
And my parents didn't feel peace.
但是我父母觉得不平安。
They said, Joshua, we feel in our spirit that you're supposed to do 6 months to a year of practical ministry first before you go to college.
父母跟我说要半年到一年的时间，我应该做一些真的实行的这个的布道，我才开始我的大学。
I have pretty radical parents.
我的父母是非常激进的。
And so I said, okay, let me pray and seek God.
我说好，我就让我祷告，让我寻求神。
And so I went in a 3-day fast.
所以我进行这个三天的禁食。
And I prayed. And I said, God, what do you want me to do?
我祷告，然后就问神，神你要我做什么？
And he said, Joshua.
他说 Joshua.
You want to raise up this army of itinerant preachers, right?
不是想要兴起这个大能军队、大能布道家吗？
Well, how do you think you're going to do it?
你觉得你要怎样做？
Do you think you're just going to get a degree in theology and people are going to follow you?
你觉得你拿了一个神学位，然后人家就会跟随你吗？
He said, No, you must go first.
他说不，你要先去。
You must set the example.
你要去设立一个好的这个榜样。
And he said, Go for 6 months.
他说 去吧，6个月的时间。
And preach the gospel across America.
然后在全美国你要去传福音。
Take no money with you.
不要带任何的钱。
Only trust in me.
只要相信我。
And I said, Okay, God.
我说好，神。
I'm ready.
我已经预备好。
I was 18.
那时候我18岁。
And I spoke to my parents.
我跟我父母说。
And my dad said, Joshua, I know you hear from God.
我爸说，Joshua，我知道你从神听见。
I bless you to do this.
我祝福你，在你身上。
And then my mom said, Lord, not my son.
我说，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不要，不
And then I spoke with my senior pastors and they blessed me to do it. And then I went into another 40-day fast. This time just water and juice. And I stayed isolated in an apartment with no human contact for 40 days. And I just sought the face of God. And during that time, he gave me the vision and the strategy of how this army would arise. And no one would go with me. All my friends said, oh, I gotta work, or I got school, or my parents won't let me go. But I believed that God would provide. So I set the date. And I said, at this day, I'm leaving. I said, God, if you want someone to go with me, you have to provide. And 2 days before I left, I met the guy that was going to be my partner. He had dreadlocks. Dreadlocks like those... And he was dressed like a punk with patches everywhere. And I thought that he was not saved. And I went to preach the gospel to him. And then when I started to tell him that I was going to go 6 months across America, he said, no way, man, that's my dream, could I go with you? I was like, don't you have a job? He's like, yeah, I don't care, I'll quit tomorrow, no problem. I was like, what about your parents? He said, they don't care. He said, I used to do drugs and all this horrible stuff, and now I'm saved. Now I follow Jesus. They don't care. They let me do this stuff. His name was Alex. Little Cuban guy, 4'11". And so me and Alex went from Miami to San Francisco for 6 months. We took no money, no car, no credit cards, just a backpack with some clothes, and my Bible. And Every day,
每一天,
our only agenda
我们, 唯一的行程,
was wake up,
就是起来,
pray for 3 or 4 hours in the morning,
三四个小时在早上门打开,
and then hit the streets for 4 to 10 hours a day preaching the gospel.
在街上4到10个小时,我们就这样子全部,
6 days a week.
一星期六天,
just Sundays, we would go to church and we would rest.
星期天我们就去教会休息一下。
And I made a rule with God. I said, God, you're the one that asked me to do this. I didn't ask to do this. And so you're my boss. And I know that if I work for a worldly boss, that he'll pay me at the end of 2 weeks or a month.
我知道我在地上的工作的时候，老板就是会半个月、一个月，他会给我工资。
So you're the best boss in the world. And I know that if I work hard for you, that you'll pay me. And so I refuse to ask anyone for anything. I said, I will not ask for money. I will not ask for food. I will not ask for a place to sleep. I will not hitchhike. I won't ask for rides. I won't take up offerings in churches. I won't raise support and send out newsletters.
我不会就是这样子发这些资料让人家去求钱给我。
And I did it. Twice I broke the rule in desperation and I asked.
在绝望的时候，就是我两次就是破坏这个规矩，然后我问。
And nothing happened.
但是没有，什么都没有。
And by God's grace,
神的恩典。
Alex and I had 3 meals a day every single day. We even gained weight on the trip. And we only spent 4 nights out of 6 months on the street. It was amazing. And those 4 nights were awesome. I wish we could have spent more nights on the street. Because there's something so precious when you literally have nothing. And all you have is Jesus. It's one of the most satisfying feelings in the world. I encourage you to feel it one day. It's amazing. And anyways, it's funny. It was funny because the first few days I actually went by myself. And then Alex joined me a couple weeks in. And it was in the first 3 days that I slept on the street. And then after that, God provided the whole time. And then Alex got jealous. And he was like, you got to sleep on the street. I didn't get to sleep on the street. I want to sleep on the street. So one day in LA, we slept on the street. And then he joined these, he went to this Hare Krishna temple. And he went by himself and I went with another family. And he lived with them for about 4 or 5 days and preached the gospel to them. And he was in one of their classes. And someone had a broken arm. And he prayed for their arm. And he was healed. And so they kicked him out. And then he stayed on the street another 2 nights. And then we met up again. So he got to stay on the street a few
nights. So he was happy.
Anyways, it's just funny. So we saw that God is faithful. If we are faithful to Him, He'll always be faithful to us. And the even more amazing thing that I've learned
更多把这个事我学到。
Is even when we're not faithful.
就算我们对神不忠心。
He's faithful to us.
他仍是那么信实可靠的神。
Which blows my mind.
就是让我就是非常的压抑。
And so since then.
从那时起。
We've trained 15 more guys.
训练了15个人。
And we've sent them across America for 6 months, and they take no money and they just preach the gospel.
跟我们一样，我们就把它花出去，拆出去六个月时间呢，不带任何钱。
Every summer, we do a training and then we send people out.
每个暑假我们就做这个训练，然后我们就拆人出去。
One thing that I did learn from this trip.
在这个旅程，我学到了一样功课。
And just throughout my life, preaching the gospel in America.
在用我的人生，我要在美国去传福音。
Is that America?
就是在美国。
Does not know the gospel.
美国不认识福音。
There's very few people that actually know the gospel.
非常少的人，他们是真的认识福音。
Most of us have this very wrong conception of America.
很多人，我们就是对美国有一个很错误的理解。
That it's a Christian nation, and everyone has heard about Jesus. Everyone has heard the gospel a million times.
我们以为就是在美国是一个基督教的国家，就是每个人都已经听过福音一万遍。
But what I found is that that's not true.
但是我发现这个不是真实的。
What people know is they know the right answers in order to pass the quiz.
他们只是知道那个可以让你小考可以过的这个的答案。
So if you ask them if they know about Jesus,
问他你认不认识关于耶稣的事。
They know. They say yes.
他说是，我认识。
And they know this. They know Jesus loves you.
知道耶稣爱你。
They know Jesus died on the cross.
知道耶稣在十字架上死。
And they know repent or you're going to hell.
他知道如果不悔改就会去到这地狱。
They all know.
他们都知道。
But when you ask them,
知道你问他。
Why did Jesus die on the cross?
为什么耶稣要在十字架上死？
They say, I don't know.
不知道。
Why does God love you?
为什么神爱你？
I don't know.
不知道。
They don't know.
不知
道。I would preach the gospel.
我会传福音。
To hundreds of people.
跟数百人。
And almost all of them, I would look them in the eyes.
一个人，我对着他眼睛说话。
And when I would get to the point of talking about the cross.
当我讲到关于十字架上的问题的时候。
I would say, so Jesus came and he died on the cross. You know that story, right?
说哦，你知道那故事吗？就是耶稣来到世界，在十字架上死了。
And they would say, yeah, yeah, yeah.
说哦，是啊，我知道。
And I would say, so what does it mean?
我说那有什么意义？
What does a man dying on a cross 2,000 years ago have to do with you right now?
有2000年前在十字架上死的人跟你有什么关系？
And 80% of the people
80%的人
would look me right in the eyes.
对着我眼睛
and say honestly,
说实的
I have no clue.
我完全不知道。
And so this is a mission field.
所以这个是一个训练我们和场。
Not just the Chinese,
不只是中国人
but the Americans,
但是美国人
the Hispanics,
西班牙人
the Blacks,
墨西哥人黑人
everybody,
每个人。
And so my challenge to you.
所以我对你们发出挑战。
Is to have God's heart for the lost. That every time you see somebody, you would not judge them. Or you would not just ignore them. But you would look at them through God's eyes, with the love of God, with the compassion of God.And that will change you forever.
那个会完全改变你。
See, the problem with us.
所以我们的问题。
Is that we're so busy.
就是我们太忙碌了。
We're so busy.
太忙碌。
That we don't have time.
我们没有时间。
To stop.
没有时间停下。
And to love someone.
去爱一个人。
For 10 minutes.
10分钟。
The other problem.
另外一个问题。
Is that we're scared.
就是我们恐惧。
And we think.That people don't want to hear about God.
我们觉得人不想认识关于不想听关于什么事情。
But what I found.
但我发现。
Is that when I approach people to talk to them about God.
当我接近人对他们讲关于神的事。
They're the ones who are scared.
他们是那个恐惧的人。
They're scared of me. It's like when you see like a snake. And you get scared. But then when you go close to it, the snake is more scared of you. It's the same thing. You see this big guy with tattoos everywhere. Piercings on his face. And you're scared of him. But then you go up to him with the boldness of God, with the love of God, and you look him right in the eyes and you ask him if he knows Jesus. And he's like, yeah, man, what's wrong? It's pretty amazing. My wife would go up to big black guys, big black
guys.
And they would get scared of her. So we shouldn't have fear. And then the other problem we have is that we judge people. I do it all the time. I look at a person, I think, man, they're so lost. They're so sinful. Look at them. They're doing drugs, and they have tattoos, and they're cussing, and they have a naked lady on their shirt. And we judge them. And we think, oh, they're such sinners. But that's the wrong mentality. That's the mentality of a Pharisee.
To
start looking at people with God's eyes. And we need to look at them and say, they're a prodigal. They're a lost son or daughter of God that just needs to come and know Jesus. And when we do that, all the judgment and all the fear just disappears. And perfect love casts out all fear. And then we're just able to love.
Put your spirit, Lord. Lord, I pray for the Leaside Temple in Hacienda Heights. That your presence, that your power would be poured out in that temple. That souls would be saved. That people would have visions of Jesus.